Hailing from that sleepy, perfect little hamlet of Etobicoke, the Rheostatics were among the first Canadian groups of the mid-80s to establish suburban Ontario as that frontier of Canada's conscious awakening musical revolution. And haven't they done it all? Touring our country, of course, Ireland, twice singing the anthem at Toronto Maple Leaf Games, don't get much bigger than that, showcasing new music seminars in New York City and in Austin, Texas, and Introducing Happiness is their third album. And here now to play for you on Midday Newsline, we're pleased to welcome the Rheostatics.
Jesus was once a teenager too, though he could walk on the water, he could not face the laughter, the tools of his feet.
Size 9.5. Extra wide.
I don't know what I like better, the shoes or the hat. Anybody has the guts to celebrate downtown Timmins is welcome on this show anytime.
It's a lovely spot in Canada.
Yeah, to be away from. Welcome to our show in our town. Dave, you obviously played the concert on the weekend. You went, you had a good time. They treated you well, no problems.
No problems, Ron.
It's a nice town, eh?
I know
Ottawa gets such a bad rap? Not as bad as Etobicoke.
It doesn't have a bad rap, I don't think. It has a good rap, good reputation.
Ottawa, you know, all those politicians and hot air. No, I like it.
The only thing, you know.
It's easy to ignore politicians.
Yeah, not if you live here all year round. God help us. Introducing happiness. They've been introducing it to us here at Rheostatics. Thank you very much, guys, for coming by, and drop by next time you're in town, too. I love your hair. Here's JC.
Well, what did vinyl do to deserve its place in the basement? Is anyone, in fact, recording on vinyl anymore? I mean, or is it always going to stay in the basement? We're going to talk to John Westhaver today, and we'll explore some of these mysteries with John, and he'll tell us. And I think the answer to that is yes, some bands are recording on vinyl.
Oh, yeah, for sure. There's a wide market for new releases on vinyl, both from older bands who are well established and, more importantly, for a lot of new bands that are just getting their feet wet, so to speak, in the first release or whatever.
Why are they recording on vinyl?
Well, first off, I mean, a lot of the do's and don'ts of releasing on whatever chosen format happens to be available today don't really include or preclude vinyl from that equation, because the vinyl business has never really died. Contrary to what some people in the media have declared, fueled probably by more or less the major labels, that no one's interested in buying the inferior format. A lot of the majors have stopped producing vinyl for the mass market. However, a lot of the newer bands, if I hate to use the word, but the alternative bands or independently oriented bands, there's still a viable market for those groups on vinyl. And it's mostly, you know, it's kids that are buying it, there are older people that are still buying it. And if you use alternative as a word to include also like the various fringe forms of music, of which jazz, blues, folk, reggae, still a huge demand for all that stuff on vinyl. So there is a demand for it. Therefore, people are still releasing on that format.
Do you think we'll see the cohesion with music that we saw in the 70s, 60s, and the 80s? I mean, just people getting together on something instead of fly-by-night bands?
Well, no, I think we've probably moved further away from that, because it's become far too easy for many people to record and release. So that gives two things. It makes for a lot of like mediocre to fairly mundane product on the market. That's not to say that's a bad thing, but there's a lot more bands around today. It's a lot easier to have access to cheaper forms of recording.
I'm going to stop you there, John, because I know you could go on, and I want you to, but okay. Thanks a lot. John Westhaver is from Birdman Sound and also CKCU. So thanks. We continue browsing.